The Missing Coach. More and more people travelled on the Fat Controller's railway. More and more ships came to the harbours. Everyone had to work very hard indeed. No one can say, grumbled Henry, that we're afraid of hard work, but we draw the line at goods trains, finished Gordon.
Dirty trucks, dirty sidings, yuck, put in James.
Silence, ordered a well-known voice. Let me tell you that an engine for goods work will arrive from Scotland tomorrow.
The news was received with acclamation. The Fat Controller stared.
Did you say two engines, Inspector?
Yes, sir.
Then send the other one back at once.
Certainly, sir, but which?
What do you mean?
The two engines are exactly alike, sir, and have no numbers. They say they lost them on the way.
The Fat Controller seized his hat.
We'll soon settle that nonsense, he said grimly.
The two engines greeted him cheerfully.
I hear you've lost your numbers, he said. How did that happen?
Only mon has slightly slip it off, sir. You ken who it is.
I know. Accidentally on purpose.
The twins looked pained.
Sir, you wouldn't be thinking we lost them on purpose.
I'm not so sure, said the Fat Controller. Now then,
what are your names?
Donald and Doogie, sir.
Good, he said. Then your controller can tell me which one of you is which.
Och, you'll no get muckle help for him, sir.
Why?
He doesn't ken our names, sir. Who could he? We only gain ourselves names when we lost our numbers.
One of you, said the Fat Controller, is playing truant. I shall find him out and send him home. Inspector, he ordered, give these engines numbers and set them to work.
Soon, workmen came to give the twins their numbers. Donald was 9 and Douglas 10. Ye may have noticed, Dougie, that yon painters forgot something.
What did they forget?
They painted braw new numbers on our tenders, but they put nane on us.
Ye mean, grinned Douglas, that we can just that?
Chuckled Donald.
Hold your wisht. Here's the inspector.
Now 9 and 10, smiled the inspector. Here's Doc. He'll show you round before you start work. The twins enjoyed themselves and were soon friends with Doc.
We like it fine here, said Donald.
That's good, smiled Doc, but take my tip. Watch out for Gordon, Henry and James. They're sure to try some nonsense.
Dinny fuss yourself, chuckled Douglas. We'll soon settle them.
Donald and Douglas had deep-toned whistles.
They sound like buses, said Gordon.
Or ships, sniggered Henry.
Tugboat Annie,
laughed Gordon.
Ha, ha.
You wouldn't he be making fun of us, would you now?
Asked Donald.
Gordon and Henry jumped. They glanced nervously from side to side.
No, said Gordon.
No, no, certainly not, said Henry.
That's fine, said Douglas.
No, just mind the bathier and keep it that way.
That was the way Gordon and Henry kept it.
Every day, punctually at 3:30, Gordon steams in with the express. It's called the Wild Nor'Wester and is full of people from England, Wales and Scotland. There is also a special coach for passengers travelling to places on Thomas's branch line. Thomas, with Annie and Clarabel, comes hurrying from the junction to fetch it. Thomas is very proud of his special coach. One afternoon, Douglas helped Duck in the yard while Donald waited to take a goods train to the other end of the line. As Duck was busy arranging Donald's trucks, Douglas offered to take away Gordon's coaches.
Douglas was enjoying himself when an awful thought struck him. I hope the Fat Controller doesn't find out I shouldn't be here. I couldn't abide going back. He worried so much over this that he forgot about Thomas's special coach. Soon Thomas came fussing. "Where's my coach?"
"Cooch?" asked Donald.
"What cooch?"
"My special coach that Gordon brings for me. It's gone. I must find it."
He bustled away.
"Losh sakes," said Douglas. "I mourn her stole the special cooch with the others."
"Now listen," said Douglas's driver. "We'll change tender. Then away with you, Donald, and tack yon goods. Dinny fash about us. Quit now. Do as I say."
A mob of angry passengers erupted from the siding, but Donald, with Douglas's tender, 10, was out and away with the goods before they came near. Douglas and his driver waited with innocent expressions.
"Ah," said the Fat Controller, "Number 9, and why have you not taken the goods?"
"My tender is a war, sir."
The driver showed him the tender, still uncoupled.
"I see. Some defect, no doubt. Tell me, why did Number 10 leave so quickly?"
"Maybe, sir," put in Douglas, "he saw you coming and thought he was late."
"Hmm," said the Fat Controller. He turned to the passengers.
"Here are the facts. Number 10 has been shunting the yard. Your coach disappeared. We investigate. Number 10, disappears too. You can draw your conclusions. Please accept my apologies. The matter will be investigated. Good afternoon."
The Fat Controller watched them till they climbed the station ramp. He swung round suddenly.
"Douglas, why are you masquerading with Donald's tender?"